I'm Pooja Rai. I'm a co-founder of Antel Creations. We aim to bring back play to children by using sustainable material, like by building playgrounds from recycled material. So when we first came to this school, we saw that there was a playground existing many years back, but from 3 years it was lying vacant because, as you can see, there was a slide which was broken. So when we spoke to the principal and the teacher, they said you can remove the entire thing and build a new one. So we took this as an opportunity to use the broken pieces and build a new playground out of these things. So we've used all the metal parts that you see. They were existing from the previous playground that was there, which children were not using from past 3 years. And we built, designed elements around those metal poles. Like, we created bridge, we created a rocket wiggler, we created swing on the metal pieces that were already existing. So we'll see the playground. So far we've built around 23 such playgrounds spread across 10 cities. There are different challenges in every city. So, yeah.
Okay, and where are the other playgrounds?
So we built our first playground in IIT Kharagpur when we were in our final year of college. And I recently visited that playground. It's still standing strong and children are having as much fun as they were having then. So it was nice to see the durability of these playgrounds. And other playgrounds. So we built it in Delhi, Pune, Auroville, even in remote areas of Hyderabad.
Okay, so could you tell us a little bit more about the material you've used, or how you started it? Were there plans involved?
So,
let's just go there.
Yeah. So the idea is we want to use recycled material, something that already exists. And tire being a very durable material, we use tire extensively. Another good thing about tire is it's available everywhere throughout the country. So it's locally available, which we can use to make playgrounds for children. And we use them in different forms. Like, we use the rims to build the walls of the bridges. We've used truck tires to build this rocket wiggler. And we've used the tread to build another bridge.
Did you have to do a lot of research for this, or
So basically, our co-founding team, we are architects from IIT Kharagpur. So initial set of designs were done by us. And then it's very contextual every place that we go. Like, here we had to do entirely new set of designs because of the metal structure that already existed, and we had to build around that what we can do. So designs keeps happening. Like, in one of our playgrounds we were working with Mahindra Susten, where they had abundance of cable drums and oil drums. So we felt that why do we buy scrap tires and then build it? We used those material to build a playground for children. So it's whatever material. So the idea is that we use locally available material at a low cost. So the two major problems why playgrounds do not exist in so many schools is, one is maintenance, and one is they're very high cost. So we're trying to reduce these two problems by using recycled material, which reduces the cost. At the same time, using materials which are durable and will last for some time.
Do you play in playgrounds often? This is the last time.
After we started building playgrounds, we get to play a lot. And I think if I compare my childhood with the children to these days, in our times our parents used to say, "Ki, stop playing and come home." Now parents say to their children that stop playing on your video games and go out. So things are changing, and we need to bring back that playful, the outside play, or the active play back again. So even in our playgrounds, this is free play. We let children do what they want to do. There's not a structure that we tell them to follow. And the kind of games they invent around these playgrounds is like super amazing. We can't even think of hundreds of ways they will think to, you know, we build a structure and we are like, okay, this is how to play on it, but children will invent like 10 more ways how to play around those elements. So I think that's the beauty of free play. So
what do you think about imagination? Like I think kids use a lot of imagination, we don't.
Yeah, I think as children they can go wild. So what we did in one of our playgrounds is so nobody asked a child, you know, what play means to them. So we played a game with them. We asked them to draw the wildest playground they can imagine. And some of them, you know, came up with things like elephants, rocket, car. So we took it as a challenge and we tried to convert that into the play element. So we created a car out of tires. We created a rocket out of tires. And I think seeing their imagination come to reality makes them more creative. So as children, yes, they are much more imaginative because we've been brought up that way, that with everything we're given a structure, a process, and there should be we have to give them some freedom for them to let their imagination so I think all of us have this child within us that we should not let die, you know. So the playgrounds that we build in metro cities and the playgrounds that we build in villages is very different, because in villages you have ample space, so we have freedom to design elements. But in government schools and in metro cities, there is constraint of space. So in one of the schools when we went, the teacher was like, my kids really need a playground. But it was just a four-story building and there was no ground where we could build a playground. So we did an interior playground for them. Because children have so much energy and they need to, you know, take out that energy in the form of play. And if they don't get to run around, play, it comes out in the form of fighting or in negative form. So we built interior playgrounds. We've also built a library. A similar problem, they did not have a space where we could build a playground. So we created a library where the seating structure was made with tires. So it became like a fun library for them. So, and more inviting. So that's one we have done.
How did you get into this? It's so unique. I mean, I've never met anyone who designs playgrounds. Were you always interested in this? Did it come along the way?
So how it started was, five of us were in, studying in our final year of college. And we went to this school called Disha Seema Care Center, which is a residential school for children in IIT Kharagpur. And we saw that children were playing with cement pipes, slippers. So we felt that these children deserve much more than this. And being architects, you know, we wanted to do something more creative and we didn't have money at that point of time. So, you know, we started thinking on what can we do. So tires came as an idea, and we built our first playground out of tires. And it took us 3 months to actually build that. What we designed on paper and what we actually did were pretty different things. But after we built our first playground, we started getting so many requests from all over the country. And that's when we realized that the need is much larger and everybody needs a playground. And like even more than 95% of the government schools do not have a proper playground. So that's when we decided that that we should take this full time, because there's a much larger need to build these playgrounds.